Hi, my name is Pedro, and this is All My Function. Today, I'm going to talk about a topic that is not very known for people that are not working on projects in real life, that is actually the bouncing and throttling. So I don't remember actually the last time that I didn't use one of them in a real project because they are very necessary. Let's start with the bouncing first. The bouncing is when you want to do a bunch of things and only fire when they stop happening, like autocomplete searches and stuff like that. Let's see how you do it. So to start the bounce function, what I'm gonna do is create an empty HTML page first. So I'm gonna use Emmet for it, so it's really easy. HTML 5. And then what I'm gonna do is create a script tag on the bottom. And I'm gonna put a console log. I'm here. And then I'm going to create an input tag that is actually pretty easy. It's just ID debounce because I want to get this by ID after. Then I'm going to add a type of text and a placeholder of debounce. Let's see how it is on the web page. So it works as expected. The console logs is here. So now what we need to do is actually get this input by ID and add an event listener to run every time that the key goes down, so on change. So let's go to document.getElementById, and then the ID is actually debounce, and then the following function is to add event listener, and the event listener is actually key down. And on key down, I want to get an event and do something with it. So I'm going to just console log e.target.value. That is actually the value of this input. So here, every time that I type something, it goes to here. Don't read this one. Like this. Meaning that if I want to create an autocomplete here or something like that, I'm going to trigger a function every time that I type. So if a person types 70 words per minute, it's going to be like a lot of letters. And every time that the person types a letter, is going to trigger a function. We don't want that. What we want is only trigger it after a person stops typing for, let's say, 1 second. To do that, I'm going to create a debounce function. So the debounce accepts two parameters. The first one is a function that is going to run, and the second one is a time that it has to wait. So here is a func and then a wait. And then the debounce function is actually a high order function, so meaning that it needs an outer scope to actually run properly, because it needs a timeout that can't run on the inner scope. I'm going to explain it later so it's easier. But first, let's create a timeout here. This is going to return a function with all the arguments that it receives. So the first thing here that I'm going to do is run the timeout and add it as a set timeout. The first parameter of the set timeout is the function. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to return that func with all the arguments. And here I'm going to make this timeout wait for the time that I pass here on this upper one. So if I run it like this, it's not going to be very good, right? What is going to happen is that whenever I type, I didn't implement it. So here I have to basically put it on the debounce. And then here I'm going to put 1 second. Then here I type, 1 second ran. It ran like 9 times. We don't want that. Why? Because we want to clear this timeout every time that this function runs. So to do that, I just need to check if the timeout exists. And if it does, then I clear it with clear interval. Actually, it's clear timeout. And then I put the timeout here. Well, with that, then I have a function that runs here, right? But if I type a bunch of things, it's only going to run like once when I stop typing. That's what we wanted, right? Good. So now you know how to debounce a function to not trigger it like a bunch of times when the user is typing or clicking on something very fast and you only want to run it once. But what if you want to do something that is actually charged per call and it has a limit of calls per second? You want to run it like all the times, but you want to only run it every 1 second. You don't want to run it more than once per second. Let's say that you have this case. To do that, you need a throttling function. And I'm going to explain how the throttling function works right now. So here we have our debounce function. Let's create a button below it. So button, I'm going to create it with a type button. And then I'm going to create ID for it. So the ID is going to be throttle. And then inside of it, the name is going to be throttle. If I click on it, nothing's going to happen. So let's say that I have this button here. Nothing's going to happen here. But if I create a function on event listener here of document.addEventListener, oops, I need to get it first, get element by ID. Then I'm going to add the throttle. Then I'm going to add event listener off click. And then I'm going to run it with the E. I want to run it clicked every time that I click on it. So let's go back to the web page. And now if I click it, it console logs clicked. What I want to do now is actually only let the user run it once per second. So I can click it as many times I want. It's only going to trigger if 1 second has passed from the last time that I clicked. To do that, it's actually pretty close to how you make a throttle function. To create the bounce function. So to create the throttle function, you need to do the same thing. Const throttle equals to func and then wait. Pretty close, right? But then the throttle is actually not measured by a set timeout this way. It's actually measured by time. And when I say that, it's actually because I want to let last time that it ran equals to zero. And then this one, just like the debounce function, is an high order function. So it returns another. So return this function with all the arguments that it receives. And here, what I want to do is I'm going to say that now is day.now. So it's gonna give me the time, the current time in milliseconds. And then what I want to do is I'm going to check if now is now minus last time is bigger than the time that I, or equal, that the time that I asked for it to wait. If so, I'm going to run the function with all the arguments and put the last time as it ran as now. Well, now I'm going to put this function here. So I'm going to put the throttle and then here I'm going to wait this time. Oh, yeah, I need to copy it out like this. Then the first argument is the function. The second argument is the wait. So no matter how many times I click, the first one is going to go. Oh, because this is getting everything as a first argument. I think I added too many things here. So basically here, now it works, but it only goes once every second. So I can click on it how many times I want. It only triggers after that 1 second is passed. Awesome, right? This can really help you with real life issues and things like searches, so you don't want to overflow your database with a bunch of calls or something that charges you per call. So it really helps in real life. I hope it helped. If you liked the video, please give a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and see you soon. Bye bye.